everybody. My name's Miss Brittany, and welcome to the Chino Community Garden for our Children's Discovery Workshop on composting today. Let's head over to our composting corrals. Right now, I'm just standing in one of our many corrals that we have for composting here at the community garden. It's just a regular pile of dirt that you would find in your front yard or your backyard, anywhere at your house. Later on, we'll be adding different elements to the dirt to kind of make it more enriching and make it an actual compost pile. But for now, it's just a regular pile of dirt with some rocks and some leaves like you would find at your house. Here we are in our second corral that we have for composting in our garden. Right now, what we have is a pile of dirt and compost that we've been working on for a while. When making a compost pile, you want to stick to the rule of greens, browns, air, and water. So greens are vegetable scraps, so it could be pieces of lettuce or spinach or different kinds of greens that you don't want to eat when you're eating dinner. It can also be fresh grass clippings and different green leaves that you find in your yard. Those are full of carbon. Then we also have browns, so that can be coffee grounds, it can be old grass clippings, small twigs, and also brown leaves that you'll find in your yard as well. So that can all be mixed into your compost pile. You need water because water helps kind of soften things for all of the decomposers, which are the bugs that will go into your compost pile and help break everything down. And we'll also need air because air kind of helps aerate the soil, it keeps it from being too compacted, and when it aerates the soil, then the composters, the bugs, can go in there and have a better chance of breaking everything down and eating all of that in the compost pile. When you're doing your compost pile, you want to make sure that you're aerating it or mixing it or turning it. And so the reason you want to do that is to keep it from stinking. So if you notice that you have a compost pile and it's starting to kind of stink, just mix it around a little bit and get some oxygen in there. That just means that things are decomposing but not really getting too much oxygen. The more you mix it and the more you turn it, the better the compost is going to decompose and the less it's going to stink. You'll know when your compost is done when it looks more like soil than it does compost. So when you are properly mixing and adding things into your compost and letting it decompose, it will look very similar to the soil that you can buy, the rich soil at the store. Now we'll head over to go take a look at our composting bins. Here we'll be talking about different composting bins. So right behind me, we have our large composting bins from Waste Management. And what these are is you can use these in place of a pile or if you don't have a direct spot for a compost pile in your yard to fill up with dirt and soil and all sorts of our greens and browns and water to help make your own compost pile. And so what is great about these is it actually has its own turning mechanism. And so you can use the top to kind of help turn the compost that's inside of the bin and you don't have to use a shovel or stir it yourself to make sure that it's turned. Here we have our smaller bin that we got from Waste Management. This is actually really great for a smaller house or your kitchen or a small backyard or garden. So this is great because it's small and compact, it can fit into a small area, and also it has these air holes on the top so it can help get the oxygen into your compost. Now let's take a look inside of our compost bin and see what we have. Here we have our small at-home compost bin. So what I've been doing is I've been adding different types of leaves and plants and some soil that I had at home, as well as putting in some vegetable scraps in there. And so what I like to do is I like to actually kind of keep this outside in almost like a cool area, just so that it gets enough oxygen here through our air holes. And I put a little bit of water in there so we get our water as well. And then I'll mix it up, I put some dirt in there, and we have a tomato here that was actually fallen and smashed a little bit, and this is perfect since we can't eat it to put into our compost bin. So we'll put it in there, we'll mix it up, and another great thing about having it outside is that we let the decomposers or those bugs that like to eat everything get into the container. And so looking in here, I can actually see some ants, I can see some pill bugs, and I can see some other beetles, and they're working really hard to kind of break everything down in here and create a really nice compost for my home garden. Thank you for joining me at the Chino Community Garden for our Discovery Workshop on compost today. Feel free to check out www.cityofchino.org/recreation for more healthy Chino tips and videos.